Dr. D.P. Vats.
Honorable Chairman, it is my proud privilege to speak on the quality control of teachers' education, and I support this bill because it is doing retrospective correction or clearing the debris left so that prospectively we don't land up in such a situation. Quality control of teachers is a very important issue, and I like to discuss in my maiden speech in this August house, where many eminent teachers are the members whom I know, and with the rest I will get conversant. Historically, India has been the Jagat Guru of the world, and Guru Shishya Parampara in the Gurukuls made the position of Gurus very eminent. Even if they used to go to Darbars, King used to get up and touch their feet. But they were Tyagi, Tapasvi and Balidani Gurus. Then came the risks on the Gurus with the invasions, because they were intellectuals and libraries were destroyed. Chinggis Khan was the biggest destroyer of libraries in Baghdad and the ulemas. When University of Dhaka crackdown took place before Bangladesh war, the butcher of Bangladesh and butcher of Balochistan, late General Tika Khan, killed the faculty of Dhaka University, and all such issues discourage the people because they are intellectuals and they run a risk to their lives and lives of their families. I myself was chairman Haryana Public Service Commission and did a lot of recruitment of teachers. To my surprise here, I find that in our country, where there are 17,649 teachers training institutes and around 30 lakh students are studying there, there is a deficiency of around 1 million teachers in the nation. Not only that, the regulatory body for quality control of teachers, that is NCTE, in itself is under fire at times. In the morning, I rang up the vice chancellor of a very famous university and asked that I selected so many teachers in thousands and why there is a shortage of teachers in the universities and in colleges and teachers' training institutes. The answer was, first, as their first option, they don't like to become teachers. If they are capable teachers, they go abroad or they join other services like civil services. Not only that, the teachers' eligibility test is so tough that less than 5% qualify. NET and even state teachers' eligibility test, only 2 or 3% qualify. I put it this way, there are many factors. Though teachers in government institutes are very well paid, but even then, as I'm mentioning, I was chairman, a professor in college or an assistant professor in college pay was more than a PCS officer or a HCS officer. But they will opt for to be an administrative officer in the state because the importance to teacher's status is not that much what is to be there as an administrative officer. Another factor I was told by the teaching authorities that the correspondence course which was making the teachers in mass has been discontinued. Why? Because fake degrees and fake teaching institutions came up in the country. There were admissions. Institutions were happy that students don't come, they don't need hostels. Faculty was also guest faculty type, which was on the record only. Students come only to appear for the exam or fill up the forms, and degrees were also questionable. Under such situations, when these shops became quite infamous, correspondence courses had to be stopped. Not only that, the recruiting agencies which recruit the teachers, they are mostly every result, especially in states, though there are recruiting of agencies like UPSC, which are unquestionable type. But state recruiting agencies, most of the results are challenged in the court of law. I don't say courts give wrong judgments, but judgments are so delayed, as we were discussing, that vacancies in the morning, Honorable Minister was saying that there is some judgment from Allahabad High Court and we will not fill up those vacancies. Now it is justice delayed for a very long time and vacancies remain as such and next recruitment also cannot be done. Under such situations, we are surplus with teachers, but exams are very tough. Not only that, whomsoever we recruit, recruiting procedures are faulty and then they are challenged and then courts also become an instrument to the delay to the extent of many, many years and institutions and students suffer. Destiny of a nation is shaped in the classrooms and classrooms are supposed to produce physically fit, mentally alert and morally upright citizens for planet Earth, ready to accept challenges. Of course, cherishing the ideals of Sanskriti, Sanskar with scientific outlook. But Sith people, which I have stated, are picked up by the foreign universities. And we all know it very well, the teachers whom I was mentioning here are also were teaching in foreign universities. Many of us are famous teachers, and universities in US, in Europe, have many, rather their base are Indian doctors and Indian teachers. The people remaining here don't qualify the exam, and our students, our universities, they suffer. We in armed forces also are running institutions, and our selection criteria are also that tough for officers because our officers are teachers in the schools of instruction. Though we are running the schools of instruction, we are very standard ones and even recognized by the foreign countries, including Armed Forces Medical College, which I was heading. But by and large, except a few universities, like Honorable Minister was mentioning, that we are struggling to come in top 100 universities of the world. Our quality control really needs to be looked into it. And I quote one incident. Somebody mentioned about me, of course, off the record, that this general doesn't listen to the politicians, but he listens to the army officers. And one brigadier sent a girl and a boy to be recruited. I recruited the girl, but the boy was rejected. And I was asked by my friend, this boy was from my place, why you rejected him? I told him, sir, I just asked him, who has sent you? He says, Brigadier such and such. I told him, go and write the spellings of Brigadier on the blackboard in front of you. And twice I gave him the chance, and he couldn't write the spellings of a Brigadier. And the Brigadier himself commented, what to speak of spellings of a Brigadier? The people, MA, and the boy was MA English first class, MPhil English first class. He says, what to speak of writing spellings of a Brigadier? MA English first class, even I have selected, at times I have examined them, they cannot make a single sentence of English correctly. Now, my state may take pride in that, but the Brigadier himself said that you did a very right thing by rejecting him. A service officer will do like that. Same was the case with many. And many examples came up of fake degrees and all that. So I will like to say here that kacche hai kam sabuche kuch zaroof zarzare rona nahi hai ek ka awa bigad gaya. Means there is a mass deterioration. And I will say again, we have to introspect and we have to change. Ek shayar ne kaha hai, khuda ne us qaum ki halat kabhi nahi badli, jise khud khyal na ho apne aap badalne ka. And apne aap badalne ke liye, we have to be honest. We have to be upright. And we have to be straightforward. As I was mentioning, the anti-corruption bill was being discussed. And a point came that even Supreme Court judges were blamed to be of doubtful integrity by Supreme Court Chief Justice's retired ones. Same way, a provision in anti-corruption bill was brought earlier, a joint secretary government permission had to be taken before he is trapped. But now it has come down to all officers, all government servants. And the reason given was that enforcement agencies and investigating agencies will not let the bureaucracy work if we give them a free hand. Or indirectly or directly, our integrity was questioned. With these such situations, we cannot produce standard teachers. And to produce standard teachers, we can speak, our false pretensions will not work. What we speak, what we say, we have to practice. To improve the quality of teachers, we have to have faculty, facilities, and material, affected material or that are students. In facilities, I will say, NCTE is a body which regulates, which accredits, and which controls the teaching facilities, standard of faculty and methodology in our country. Therefore, the facility of electronic devices, facility of standard classrooms, facility of language labs, and facility of excellent curricula have to be there. The builders of nation have to opt for this career. Once Chancellor of Germany Angela Merkel was questioned that rest of the services asked for the parity of pay with teachers. And she said, how can you match your builders? Now such builders have to come voluntarily. And we have to grade them like our IIMs, our IITs, our AIMS, our AFMCs. They are a class apart, at least in our country. That is the class one gradation of teachers. Those are export material, I will say. Then they are good type, they are satisfactory type, and poor type have to be debarred after being given a chance. For such teachers to be produced, they have to be well paid, very well paid, at par with the best in the world, so that we stop the brain drain. Though I myself personally is in favor of brain drain, because they are a part of Indian diaspora, and certainly whensoever our Prime Minister goes abroad, they come in big crowds, whether it is London, New York, or Toronto. Let there be brain drain, but let us produce more. Now, we say they will not pass because the exam is tough. They don't volunteer for it, and there is a attrition. In such situations, I will say extremes are always wrong. Truth lies in between, and that truth is, hamara kaam chalane ke liye, hum average bhi accept karein so that our students don't remain unattended. In the end, I will say, let us respect our teachers. Let us look after them. Let teachers take pride in themselves. I am from a school, a village school, where I sat on the ground. Of course, I am a teacher's son. And my observation, as I was an advisor to UPSC on civil services also, though teachers themselves are not very well looked after, but maximum officers in armed forces and maximum civil servants are also teachers' sons. Of course, in armed forces, there are the sons of JCOs and other ranks also who take pride to be armed forces officers. Certainly, we have to keep doing a continued assessment, mid-course corrections of the teaching faculty. And with these measures, of course, as on today's situation is that in a UNESCO survey out of 128 countries, we stand at 105th rank, 105th rank, which is a very low rank. But it should not discourage us to improve. Out of our around 17,649 teaching institutions, 90% are private. Now, Honorable Minister, this bill amendment is for government institutions or government-aided, state government-aided institutions. Or we can say we are pulling up the government institutions. I hope it stands the scrutiny of law when non-government institutions knock at the doors of court. Because in case of Medical Council of India, this has happened. Because when you asked for an affidavit from the private institutions, only 300 came forward to give that affidavit, 800 promised they are giving, but degrees are still being given. And those degrees, of course, from government institutions we will be accepting, but from private institutions we have not yet sought a remedy. In the end, I will say, with these measures, Takshashila Nalanda ka itihas lot ke aayega, Bharat ki gaurav gatha ko Narendra Modi dhuraayega, and for that matter I will say, Prakash Javadekar dhuraayega. Jai Hind.